Akia Jacola, Executive Director of Cat Depot here in Sarasota, Florida. We are your resource for cat adoption, cat care, veterinary care, and education programs. And tonight we have with us some kittens and a very special guest. This show, Kindness Matters, is a show that explores our relationship with all the living things around us, from the pets that live in our homes, to the birds in the trees, to the magnificent animals that live here offshore. We all share our homes and our environments with all manner of beasts. So understanding and celebrating those relationships, in turn, gives us great joy. In my life, animals have always played a significant role, and I reflect daily on all of those joys, the successes I've had, the celebrations surrounding my relationships with animals. Plain and simple, they just really make me happy and they make me smile. So during this show, we hope to share some of that joy, share a smile, and we're all going to learn something along the way. I can assure you of that. So here we are tonight. It's the end of summer in a year that just isn't seeming to end, but it didn't seem to really start either. But this past week, we have celebrated National Take Your Cat to the Vet Day. And why is this important? Because just like us, cats and all of your pets need doctors, and they need a health plan too. Cats need regular checkups, vaccines, dental exams, cleaning. They need preventative medications. They need lab work, all the same things that my doctor recommends for me. Our pets at home need that too. So just at Cat Depot, we not only have a shelter veterinary clinic that caters to our adoptable cats and kittens, but we have an affordable cat care clinic for the public. So we're going to talk about both of those a little bit this evening. So our shelter medicine program, our veterinary clinic for the cats that are coming for adoption, kind of goes a little bit like this. When a cat first arrives at Cat Depot, whether it's coming in as a transfer from a municipal shelter, whether it's coming from animal control, another rescue, from an owner surrender, someone who can no longer care for their pet, or even from the community, the cats at Cat Depot receive specialized veterinary care really from top to bottom, head to tail. They receive an exam on admittance, and I believe these guys receive probably their second exam today. We gather whatever history we can on the animal. We find out whether it's spayed or neutered. If it's not, it does get spayed or neutered at Cat Depot. It's vaccinated, microchipped, and it's also treated for any veterinary concerns. Concerns, the medical concerns they might have might not be simple. They may have broken bones, they might have parasites, abscesses, they might have eye or teeth problems, they could possibly have chronic conditions, you name it. Sometimes the cats stay in-house with our medical and cat care teams, and sometimes they go out to foster. It really depends on what is the best situation for each individual cat's needs. Regardless, we meet those needs, and even if we need to send the cats to a specialty hospital, we do that. Mind you, all that I'm describing can get quite expensive, and our adoption charges typically are only $75 to $100, except for specialty breeds. So those fees don't even factor in our costs in caring for each cat. If you took an average, just looking at our total budget, we'd be looking at over $1,500 per cat, which is why we are so grateful for your kindness and your support. These cats and kittens couldn't survive without your generous support and our experience and expertise at Cat Depot. Right now, we have 80 cats in-house, over two-thirds of which are undergoing some sort of medical treatment. So if you check our website, you can view the adoptable cats. I need to mention also, we have about 50 to 60 cats in foster homes with volunteers at any given time as well. So you can view the adoptable cats on our website, catdepot.org. Also on the homepage, helping us get through these busy summer months, there is a donate button. So we appreciate you contributing toward their medical care, toward their general care, signing up for monthly gifts, giving. You can specify your wishes with your donation, but rest assured, your support saves lives and it helps cats such as these kittens that we brought here today. I have one sleepy kitty with me, and we've got a few more running around and a couple kind of exploring and waiting in the wings as well. They're about 2 months old. These are the Disney kittens we have brought on set with us: Prince Charming, Snow White, Cinderella, Belle, and Aurora. So they aren't quite ready for adoption, but they are in-house and they're in process, as I've described. I think they might be slated for their little surgeries tomorrow. Now, these kittens, as I mentioned, are 2 months old. They are from the same litter, and some of them have extra digits. They have extra toes. They are polydactyls. Sometimes these are known as Hemingway cats, and they're just fascinating, just learning about that, and we'll talk more about that sometime in the future. But these cats are just super cute, cuddly, very healthy, and they will be soon ready to go home. And you are chilling out quite a bit. They are typical kittens, though. They're pistols. Like I mentioned, we kind of have the five broken up into a couple groups here on set. We also have many amazing adult cats. Ooh, now you woke up. Okay. We have adult cats available for adoption as well, if you're not quite ready for a kitten. The adoption process is really a conversation with our adoption counselors to get to know you, to get to know about your lifestyle and your expectations in a cat, and to get to know the cats. We are open by appointment only, and you need to call for an appointment, 941-366-2404, and we will be open again tomorrow. Fascinating, isn't it? For those of you who have already adopted and have cats at home, and some who are already clients in our cat care clinic, we've got some very exciting news. We absolutely miss interacting with everyone in person, and I really miss people. But until we're assured that it's safe to do so, and maybe even after, we have installed a new technology in our cat care clinic. It's an app that you'll load onto your phone called Pet Pro Connect, and it's designed to help keep you safe and in the safety of your own vehicle while you bring your cats to our clinic to see the veterinary nurses and the veterinarian. So your cat will go into the clinic, and basically you'll be having a video chat and a consult with the veterinarian while your cat's in the clinic and you're waiting in the car. And I'm honestly not sure of if anyone else is using this in the area. It's super cool. I'm very excited about it. I did try it out firsthand, so we'll give you a sneak peek of how that works right now. Connect is this really neat software that the Cat Depot Veterinary Clinic is using right now. So even though we have to wait in our cars while our cats are seeing the doctor, that keeps us safe and we can be socially distanced, but we can beam ourselves in virtually to be in the room with the cat and speak to the doctor and the technician. So we're super excited. We're just launching this. We're kind of in a soft launch phase right now, but if you're a client of the Cat Care Clinic here at Cat Depot, we have new ways to assist and serve you and your cats. Give our clinic a call. Woo! 941-366-CATS. Everybody's very excited about Pet Pro Connect. The staff can walk you through how the app works. And if you're an existing client, again, you can download the app ahead of time before you arrive. Our cat care clinic at Cat Depot, that's a lot of C's in there. I can say that fast. Cat care clinic at Cat Depot, we are full service. We provide wellness exams, spay neuter services, blood blood work, microchips, x-rays, surgeries, dentals, and a whole lot more for kittens and cats. We are a feline-only practice, so we can keep you and your wiggly kittens our first priority. We are competitively priced to provide affordable care, and the clinic was established in 2014. Oh my goodness me, you're gonna go back with your friends or you wanna sit here a minute? What you want? What you want? Are you a wiggly kitten? Yeah, you are a wiggly kitten. The clinic proudly serves over 6,000 cats per year. We would be delighted to serve you. Again, give us a call, 941-366-CATS, and that's our clinic. All right, now you're gonna nap again. We are so thankful for all of our contributors, and our sponsors of this episode. We have Oasis Opera for Animals Singing is Saving. Shout out to Carol and Randy. You guys are awesome. Thank you. David Myers and the Sarasota Film Society. We worked with a little collaboration on this, and I thank you as well. And I think First Run Films are coming back, if I'm getting that right. So very excited about that. And we are thrilled to be in studio here at Mars Vision Productions. And tonight, in addition to kittens, we've got as a guest Pam Freni from the Manatee Animal Shelter. Friends of Manatee Animal Shelter, I get that right, and president of Animal Network. Welcome, Pam.
Yes, thank you very much. It's nice to be here. I'm actually a former member of Friends of Manatee County Animal Services, and I'm president of Animal Network now.
Thank you. I will get that right. I knew there were multiple titles, and I've been delighted to know you almost going on 2 years.
Yeah, it's been
now.
2 years, hasn't it?
Time goes so fast. And tell me where you come from. Where did you grow up?
Well, I grew up on a ranch in Texas, which of course gave me a love for animals and all sorts of creatures. We had everything there, you know, chickens and peafowl, cats and kittens and, you know, horses, the whole business. It was a very unusual way to grow up.
Oh, wow. And when did you move to Florida?
Actually, I sort of took a long way around. I spent 35 years in Washington, D.C. and then moved to Florida in 2014 when I retired here.
Okay, and you retired from?
I was a financial analyst for the federal government. I worked for the Federal Aviation Administration.
You have a friend there trying to jump in your lap.
And it was a wonderful career, and I enjoyed so much of it. But now I'm here, and I have an opportunity to do my second love now. Actually, it's my first love, was, you know, taking care of creatures and doing all sorts of projects for them to make sure that they have a wonderful place to live.
And how did you get involved with the manatee shelters?
Well, one of the interesting things was when my husband and I were looking for a place to retire in Florida, we surveyed a lot of the area. One night, after we'd flown in to the airport and driven down here, we were going through downtown Bradenton, and there on the side of a building, the words were "no kill." And I told my husband then, I said, "I don't know where our house is going to be, but we're living in this county."
That's a great story.
That was very exciting to know that this county in 2011 had actually put together a no-kill effort. And, you know, you don't go no-kill immediately, but it took them several years. But that was their mandate. We are going no-kill. And so to have a shelter like that in my own backyard was very exciting to work with.
So did you found Animal Network?
No. Animal Network has been in the county for well over 20 years. It was founded by a couple of intrepid ladies, one of whom is still on the board of directors. And there's been other boards of directors, and they were gracious enough to decide I had something to add to it. And they asked me to be president 3 years ago.
Wow.
And it has been very exciting.
That's a big job.
It a lot larger than you realize.
And what's an average day like for you then?
Well, before COVID, an average day was putting 300 miles on my vehicle as I went from meeting to meeting, talking to people, making sure that everyone understood what we were doing and what we could do and what the outlook was for a big new project that we're doing.
And describe that project.
Well, the new project is It is a new county shelter for Manatee County, and I'm very excited to be able to speak about it because in April of 2019, the Manatee County Commissioners allocated a significant amount of money toward it, $8 million. But the problem was we had done our research and realized that with the growing number of people that were coming into Manatee County permanently, there's nearly 10,000 people a year who are adding to our county population.
Wow.
And knowing that the shelter that could be done for $8 million probably was not going to be large enough for long enough. And so Animal Network decided that we should add $2 million to the budget. And so that's our big project for Animal Network.
And how long have you been fundraising?
We've been fundraising for almost exactly a year.
Oh.
And, you know, we were really doing well. And then, of course, COVID shut down a lot of the face-to-face stuff we were doing so that we were approaching people and having events and everything. That has put a considerable damper on what we're doing. And so we're way behind in what we should be doing because we only have another approximately a year to have it all done. And so we are at 200,000 and we're hoping to find others who would like to help us and join us in this passion that we have. We have a shelter now that was built in the 1940s. It's a World War II relic. And so based on that, we really know that it's not going to hold together much longer.
Right.
We know that it's much too small. It was built for 80 dogs. Last year, one day I was out during the summer, and there were well over 180 dogs there.
Wow,
yeah,
180.
Yeah, 180. And, you know, it's the staff does an incredible job. The volunteers are great. And so, you know, they're doing the best they can, but it's an old shelter. It has old surfaces. It's hard to keep it clean, even though they work very hard at it. And so we need a new one. And I'm trying to tell everybody that we need it now.
And so the master planning has been done, and you're just basically you just need to fundraise so you can power through and get it done.
Well, the master planning, I believe, has been done. It's a county entity, so you know I am a private organization, and we are fundraising. But I believe right now they're in the process of putting together an RFP, a request for proposal, mm-hmm. and at some point soon we will probably see it go public. It has not yet, as far as I know. It will, of course, go through their contracting process, and I'm hoping that late next year or early in 2022, we will have the groundbreaking.
Okay.
And that's just my estimation of the
time
frame.
That seems to be going fast, then.
Well, but I haven't had that word from the county yet,
I understand.
Official.
And, okay. Hi, Boom. Little guy.
I gotcha.
You got
gotcha.
Yes, you did.
Gotcha.
Great cats.
I gotcha. I've had kittens before. I know
so
how this works.
So not only does Manatee Animal Services deal with dogs, but also cats and kittens.
Cats and
you're
kittens.
Very, very adept. And as we mentioned before you're looking for to bring kittens into your life, you need to be aware that they are all over the place like three-year-olds,
they are
right?
Wonderful. They are wonderful. If they're not climbing the curtains, it's not happening.
Yes. Yes, very happy, healthy kittens we've got.
These are marvelous. And the polydactyl, it is fabulous. Look at their little feet. They're wonderful.
We can see those, but yeah, kitten with mittens.
Yeah.
Awesome. And so back to the fundraising part. So even though we are in challenging times and we all recognize that, and we're all still doing the same great work that needs to be done and saving lives and helping people who love animals as well, you guys did something kind of neat here and you brought me beer.
Well, we had a lot of fun. In January, we did a collaborative effort with Motorworks Brewing and the Manatee County Animal Services, and we put adoptable dogs on an award-winning brew from Motorworks, and put the pictures of the adoptable dogs and put the information about Shelter Manatee, which is what the fundraising effort is called. It is Shelter Manatee, and so we put sheltermanatee.com in on the back, talking about you can give to the new shelter, and so from that, we had great, great response. It was amazing. The local response in January, the news response was exciting. But when I turned on the television one day and saw that beer on the Ellen DeGeneres show.
Oh, awesome.
Like, wow. And it was NBC Nightly News. It was People Magazine. It was ABC.
That's great.
I quit counting after I counted the 200th news feed on the internet.
Fantastic.
Yeah, it truly went viral. We were very excited about it. So from that, Motorworks has graciously continued. And so we have recently released this beer. And it's the same award-winning beer, but it's available in a six-pack. The original four-pack was only available at Motor Works, and it sold out really quickly. So they wanted to continue, and they made a six-pack that is available for distribution, and hopefully it will show up in some of the local stores that have beer and wine. And then they've just chosen three new dogs to continue the effort from the shelter, and they've been photographed, and the cans are being established, and within a couple of weeks, we should have completely new dogs on the front of the beer cans that need adopting.
So these dogs have probably long since been adopted.
Those have, yes. Uh-huh.
Okay. And so is it the same kind of beer?
It is.
And these are cold.
Those are cold.
So I can try the beer?
You may try the beer.
All right, I'm going to taste
it. You may try the beer.
This is Adoptable Lager,
yes.
Motor Works. And
uh-huh.
Who do we... We have Candy.
Yes.
And we have her her animal ID number on the
correct.
Back as
that's
well.
Correct. Uh-huh.
And Candy is still adoptable?
She was adopted already. That's why we chose three new doggies,
okay.
Because Candy has been adopted.
Okay.
And so...
Congratulations, Candy.
That's right. You want some? Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you like that?
That's a nice...
It's an award winner.
Nice beer for a summer
yeah.
evening. Yes,
it's very exciting.
All right.
Yes. So we continue to...
Would you like one?
No, thank you. We continue to try to highlight the wonderful adoptable dogs that are at the shelter, along while we're also talking about Shelter Manatee, which, of course, is our effort to build an entirely new shelter.
Mm-hmm. But... So what's the rub? No cats?
Well, you know, I don't think cats and beer go well, but...
Sure they do. We're doing it now.
But the fun thing about all of this is that I figured that cats and coffee would go well.
It has a ring.
So we're in the process of creating new coffee with a relationship with Banyan Coffee Company, which is in Manatee County, and we're working on that. It should be available within the next few weeks, and when it is, you'll see it on our Facebook page. And of course, all the proceeds from all this go into Shelter Manatee.
You are determined.
He is right. Determined. Yeah. Those.
Hi. You can spring higher because you have extra toes?
That's what it is.
Yes.
So we will have cat coffee. You will be able to brew the perfect,
P-U-R-perfect,
yes. coffee with this new brew.
And you're purring. Hi, you're purring. You just want to get passed around for love. Yeah, everybody loves you because you're a kitten.
We've got another one who thinks he's got paws.
Oh, my goodness.
Here we go. Let's see what we got here.
So, how many pets do you have at home now?
I have a 17-year-old tuxedo cat that has traveled everywhere with me. He makes the trip back and forth between here and Virginia when I go back to do business there. And so he is a big, big cat, sleeps with me every night. He's my big baby. And that's what I have at home.
Okay. Awesome. Well, yeah, you'll get your fill of kittens tonight for sure. Anything you'd like to add about the shelter or your project before we go into some rapid fire?
Well, yes. One of the things that we do is mention to everybody about who is supporting us that, you know, we're a pack thing. We've got dogs and we've got packs of cats, although they don't normally come in packs. And we like to tell everybody that they can join our pack. And so thank you so much for having us today. We would like for you to join the pack.
Oh, I would love that. And I love the blue.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah.
We will join the pack, won't we?
Yeah.
You can be part of it too.
So I want to tell everybody that you can get information on our Facebook page at Shelter Manatee or on our website is where our information for donation is at sheltermanatee.com. And then if people have information or money that they would like to support us with. There's also an opportunity to put it into our account at the Manatee Community Foundation. All they have to do is call there and ask for how they can support us through putting funds into the account.
Great.
For the new animal shelter.
I'm looking forward to seeing the plans for that.
I'm so excited about it.
That'll
it's going
be
to be
fantastic.
Lovely.
Fantastic. Mm-hmm. Your favorite pet of all time? Quick.
Zilly, my current cat.
Okay, the best pet's name you've ever heard. It might be that one.
Well, it could be. Zilly would be probably the best one.
And who's Zilly named after?
Godzilla.
Oh. Okay.
It was a giant in a litter of four, and it was like seeing this huge cat. So his name was Godzilla, which got shortened to Zilla.
I like that. Favorite adventure you've ever had?
Oh, going to best friends in Utah and working a week out there for year after year after year, because it's such a fabulous location. I would go back tomorrow given the opportunity.
I have not yet been.
It is amazing. Been out there six times.
Utah is beautiful.
It is. It's truly lovely.
Absolutely beautiful. So when you can travel again, is that where you're going to go?
Probably. That sounds like a good idea. I haven't been out there in a few years, and it would be a good place to go and chill out a little bit.
All right. What makes you laugh?
Oh, kittens. Kittens always make me laugh.
And you are purring and making all sorts of cute noises. You have a motor running. Yeah, you do. You do have a motor running. All right. Anything else we should talk about? Kittens with mittens, beer?
Kittens with mittens, beer?
I feel complete.
How much better could it be?
I don't know. Yeah. I don't know. So I thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much. It's been lovely.
Wish you luck with your endeavors. And again, very exciting, all kinds of things going on. Thank you again to Oasis, Opera for Animals, Singing is Saving, to the Sarasota Film Society, to Mars Vision Productions, and of course, Team Cat Depot. reminder, Cat Depot is a 501c3 nonprofit doing good in the world for cats and people that love them. We are launching more virtual opportunities, and we are so standing by to come back to the in-person opportunities. But watch for things like our Namaste Yoga online, $10 donation per class. You receive professional instruction, comes to you in the safety of your own home. You can do yoga with your whole family and with your pets. So very fun. And speaking of getting fit, if you want to get fit for felines, I love this, please sign up for Cat Depot's Fall Feline Fun Run. We can get a team together. We can do this. We can socially distance and get her done. Go to our website. It will direct you on how to sign up. Keep an eye out in our social media. And this is going to be our largest fundraiser for Cat Depot in the fall. And we have so many kittens and cats in our care now that obviously we do need to fundraise. Very important. So each contribution, registration, donation will be matched dollar for dollar up to $50,000 for this event. If you'd like to sponsor, we will list you on our registration page as a sponsor, also in our social media. My goal is to see at least 1,000 participants nationwide. Pam's gonna run with me, right? I'm not a runner, but I'd like to see friends of friends run. I'd like to see teams of Zoom runs. You could walk your dog, walk your horse, walk next door, walk in nature. I'd love it if our friends in the farthest reaches across the world could run on behalf of cats everywhere. So whether you run, walk, roll, pace around your living room or your patio, it's all good. It can take you a month. It can take you an hour. We're just doing this on behalf of serving cats and people who love them. You can get out a little bit. You can get fit, and we'll stay safe and socially distanced while doing so. So next month on Kindness Matters, we will be pleased to be back here at Mars Vision Productions and welcome Esther Holt from Star Financial Solutions. Esther is an avid cat lover, and she's going to help us sift through some information on planning, saving, and giving. And of course, we will have animals with us. And you are just purring so loudly. I don't know if that picks up or not, but it's super cute. We will, of course, have animals with us next month, share some more stories, some memories, hopefully bring you some more smiles and tug at some heartstrings. We're going to try and share more in-depth stories from Cat Depot. And if you would like to chime in here on our news feed, let us know what you'd like us to talk about, what you'd like to talk about, what you'd like to hear about, what you'd like to learn about. Until then, if you need Cat Depot, we're here for you. Make an appointment. Give us a call, 941-366-2404. And due to COVID-19, still can't just drop in. But visit us on the web. Comment here on the news feed. Share, share, share. Hit that share button. Help us save lives. And if you can be anything in this world, please be kind. And let's all explore together how kindness matters.
Listen to you.
Yeah.